So, ladies and gentlemen, today we are going to discuss a bit on a planet which we rarely discuss. And that's Mercury. Most of the times, Mercury and Mars, they are not in limelight. Most of the times, we have Saturn, Rahu, Ketu. Not even Ketu, it's Saturn, Rahu, and Venus. These three are in limelight almost all of the times. And sometimes Jupiter and Sun are also, sometimes Moon also, but this planet is always ignored. This planet is never discussed much anywhere or everywhere. So let's discuss a few things which we already know, but we need to stress upon. So, for example, let's talk of the Karaka. Mercury is the Karaka for the 10th house. He's the primary Karaka for the 10th house. He's a very, very, very crucial planet in the horoscope. Why do I say this? Not because he's just a Karaka, but because he's the Karaka for the 10th house, which is a very important house. It's the most powerful or most influential Kendra house. Now, many times people they misunderstand the 10th house. They think, oh, this how this gives the person a lot of name, fame, success, which is true. There is no doubt about it. But there are many other things about the 10th house which we do not know. So, for example, the 10th house is also the house of discipline because you see, Sun and Saturn are the Karakas also for the 10th house. Apart from Mercury, he's the primary Karaka, of course. He's the Karaka for skill. And Sun is the Karaka for name, fame, recognition. And Saturn is the Karaka for hard work. So therefore, the aspect of discipline comes from Sun and Saturn. So therefore, if Mercury is well placed in your horoscope, then it can help you to be more disciplined in life. Because if Mercury is not well placed, then it's like saying the primary Karaka for the 10th house is not well placed, and therefore it becomes very difficult to cultivate discipline in our life also, because then the aspects of Sun and Saturn, which are related to the 10th house, they also suffer, okay, because the primary Karaka is not well placed. So how do you know how your Mercury is placed? Well, you can see that using astrology. For example, where Mercury is placed, what kind of sign is it placed in for Mercury? Does Mercury like to be in that sign? Or does Mercury hate to be in that sign? Or is he neutral there? What's going on? What's going on with Mercury's natural friends like Saturn and Venus? Where are these placed? Are they helping Mercury or are they not able to help Mercury? Where is Mercury's dispositor? How is Mercury placed in the Navamsha? Which planets are aspecting Mercury? Which houses does Mercury rule? This is also something very important which we should consider. And then at the end of the day, you check the divisional charts, the Navamsha, the Dashamsha. They will tell you what kind of flavors your Mercury is going to undergo during its dashas, okay? Because in Vedic astrology, the results of a planet comes during the dashas, right? So that's very crucial for Mercury. And as usual, if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it below. And if you want a consultation from me, then please go to my website down below in the description section. And yes, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and he will be there. So Mercury is, as you know, he's the Karaka for the 10th house. So therefore, if you feel that you are not having a good 10th house, which means 10th house is also the house of resolutions. You take a resolution, like in New Year's Day, people take resolutions that yes, I will lose 10 kg weight. I will learn some new skill. I will take up a new hobby. But that seldom happens. We see that people fail miserably when it comes to implementing and sticking to their decisions. Many people think that, oh, that's because of a bad sun, but that can also happen if Mercury is not well placed because Mercury is the Karaka for being focused in one particular area of life. Okay, now it's very interesting. Mercury is a very versatile planet, he's also the indicator of multiplicity At the same time, he's the indicator of focus also. So how is it that he's giving you focus, and focus means focusing on one thing, and he's giving you multiplicity? Does it mean that you are running here, there? So that's the test of Mercury. If Mercury is well placed, when you are doing one thing, you will be able to focus in that thing. Your mind will be focused. Okay. And when I say mind, I don't mean literally the emotional side. It's more than intellectual side. Actually, it's the intelligence which focuses on one thing. Okay. So if your Mercury is well placed, how to know that your Mercury is well placed or not? Can you focus on one thing in life? Or are you, you know, just hovering around, you know, 10 different things, and at the end of the day, you end up achieving nothing? So does it sound like someone? If yes, then your Mercury may not be very well placed. Doesn't matter where it's as per astrology. It may even be in Virgo, but then due to some other reason, you may encounter these effects. Okay, and then this is very important. And on the other side, if Mercury is even better placed, then what will happen is you'll be able to focus on one thing at a time, and you'll be able to keep your eyes off distractions and keep an eye on other opportunities which are there. This can happen especially in terms of your career. So sometimes we become too much caught up in one thing and we lose the bird's eye view from the top. So, or sometimes we are sitting at the top and doing nothing in the ground. So a healthy Mercury, a good Mercury, will give you focus when required, and it will give you the ability to diverge yourself when required, when it's the need of the hour. So therefore, this is how you can see how your Mercury is. Okay, and generally Mercury, people say that Mercury is the Kara for learning and all this. Well, that's there, but learning and all this is from many other houses, from the fifth house, the fourth house, the ninth house. Okay, so many times people think that if somebody can do very good mathematical calculation, that person has a very good Mercury, which can be true, but not necessarily. Mathematics comes from the second house, because second house is the house of counting. Okay, so it's not necessary that if you are bad in mathematics, your Mercury is very bad. It's not like that. Okay? Many times people tell me and they get disheartened. So I'm telling you, it's not like this. So if the second house is somehow related with a bad Mercury, then it can happen. But it's not necessary that everybody has to be good in counting or accounts or something like this. Okay. It's not necessary. It's not mandatory 100%. So don't think like that. So therefore, and Mercury, as you know, is the Karaga for communication. Okay, Mercury is the ruler of Gemini. So a healthy Mercury can give you the ability to see from your perspective and from that person's perspective. Okay, so therefore, if Mercury is good in the chart, in fact, Ryan Kurzak is one of the great astrologers. He had come to my channel long back, I guess 2 years back, I guess, or maybe 1.5 years back. He's one of the best astrologers I've seen. So he had said, I guess, in my channel or in some other video, I don't remember exactly, but he had said once that Mercury is very important. You know, it's like, if Mercury is well placed, then the person has the ability to, you know, negotiate and go through life, and go through doesn't mean just go through, but somehow find a way to get things done. Okay? So therefore, Mercury is very important when it comes to any area of life. It's not just that it is the character of the 10th house, so it's important for career. It's not like that. If your Mercury is not well placed, you may not only suffer in career, you may also suffer in relationships. Okay, you may not be able to communicate properly with your spouse, or there can be stubbornness if Mercury is in an unhappy sign. Unhappy sign means like enemy sign. Then there could be stubbornness, because of which Mercury is like, oh, I will only listen to myself. It's like my way or the highway. Okay, I won't listen to anybody else. So then you lose the quality of Gemini. And if Mercury is well placed, then you can understand other people's viewpoints. So that makes you a great communicator, a great leader also. You become very popular if Mercury is well placed, and that's why he's known as the prince. Okay, So therefore, Mercury is a very important planet, and many times we just ignore Mercury. We say, oh, it's, you know, just a planet. You know, after all, it shows some communication and money and all this. No, it's not like that. It controls all. In fact, the entire material world today is under the control of Mercury. The entire material world. It's like money, basically. Mercury represents money. Okay, so therefore, it's very crucial that we strengthen our Mercury by reading the scripture, especially because Mercury is represented by Lord Vishnu himself. So therefore, we should read the scriptures. We should listen to our gurus, Jupiter. Jupiter also strengthens Mercury. So it's important that we learn from, because Mercury is the student. You know, so a student has to learn. The dharma of a student is to take shelter of a guru. Okay? Because one who has not learned properly cannot teach others. Okay? So therefore, it's very crucial that we be in contact with our mentors and we read books which elevate our consciousness, not just we. And Mercury is everything, basically. You know, all the communication of the world. When I see something and I understand, that's Mercury, basically. You know, how I interpret things, you know, perspective. You may see one thing and you may think that, oh, according to me, it is like this. But another person sees that and says, no, according to me, it's like that. So how do you decide which is your perspective? So that will be decided by Mercury. Okay? How do you take things in life? You know, are you like too much argumentative or too much skeptical, or are you humble? Are you submissive, or are you too arrogant, or you are too pessimistic? All these things have to be seen by Mercury. So it's literally controlling the, imagine there was no Mercury. There'll be no interaction with people, you know. How do you feel? Imagine. So that's how important Mercury is. Okay. So strengthen your Mercury and don't let it just be one of the nine planets. Okay. It doesn't do good to our life if you do it like this. Okay. So therefore, we can also fast on Wednesdays, and Mercury likes the color green. So wearing green also enhances Mercury. Okay. And there are so many things which we can do depending on our horoscope, where Mercury sits, which houses he rules, and which planets are aspecting him, and which dashas are you running. Okay. That will be all from my side. And I'm very sure the things which I said in this video, you already know 99% of those things, or maybe 100%. But why did I still say all this? Because it is important that we give importance to this planet. Otherwise, you will see great placements, Mahapurush Yogas, you know, Raj Yogas, but they don't fructify, because Mercury, if not well placed, a person doesn't have that intelligence of how to use different things in life, how to use opportunities. Okay? Opportunities will come or not will depend on the horoscope and the dashas, but you should also be able to use the opportunities. Okay, so if Mercury is well placed, you can make the best use of a bad bargain. That is why Mercury is very, very, very crucial. Right, thank you very much for your patience and for watching this video. If you like it, click the thumbs up and share it with somebody who you know wants to improve their Mercury. Okay, and if you're new to the channel, then please subscribe to it below, and my website for consultations is also below. Okay, God is there with you all the time. Just look to him and you will find him.